Jailed conman Sukesh Chandrasekhar, who is facing several charges of corruption under the Prevention of Corruption Act and Money Laundering Act, has written another letter to Delhi Lieutenant Governor Vinay Kumar Saxena requesting a CBI probe against the Aam Aadmi Party. In his latest letter to Delhi Lieutenant, Chandrasekhar wrote, "I request you to direct an urgent CBI investigation and allow me to file an FIR as the pressure is getting too much and any undue event may take place before the truth about AAP is exposed," he wrote. Alleging that he's being threatened by AAP leader Satyendra Jain, an ex-DG of Tihar Jail, after his complaints to Delhi Lieutenant Governor went public, he said, "After my last application was released in media from last 2 days, there has been a severe threat that I have been receiving from the jail administration on behalf of Mr. Satyendra Jain and DG Prison Sandeep Goyal." The Bharat Jodo Yatra, which started on September 7th and is completed over 500 kilometers covering 5 southern states of Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Telangana, will enter Maharashtra on the 9th of November, the 61st day of the Yatra. The Bharat Jodo Yatra is scheduled to arrive at Deglur in Nanded district of Maharashtra from neighboring Telangana around 7 p.m. on November 7th today. In Maharashtra, the Yatra will travel through 385 kilometers covering 15 assembly and 6 parliamentary constituencies during its 14-day sojourn. The Yatra will resume at 10:10 p.m. following the welcome ceremony where participants will carry Ekta Marshals, that is, unity torches. The Supreme Court on Monday allowed Jharkhand Chief Minister Hemant Soren's appeal challenging the Jharkhand High Court order which accepted the maintainability of a public interest litigation in connection with ED probes into shell companies allegedly related to Soren and his associates. The case is related to mining lease awarded under Soren's government. The Jharkhand government had filed a special leave petition in the Apex Court challenging the Jharkhand High Court's order on the maintainability of the PIL in connection with shell companies allegedly related to Hemant Soren and his associates. The Supreme Court on Monday upheld the 10% quota for economically weaker sections in public jobs, public and private education institutions in 3-2 split verdict. The Supreme Court pronounced a judgment on a batch of pleas challenging the validity of the 103rd Constitution Amendment providing 10% reservation to EWS persons in admission and government jobs. A 5-judge constitution bench headed by Chief Justice Uday Umesh Lalit delivered the verdict in the matter. CJI UU Lalit and Justice Ravindra Bhatt struck down the EWS amendment. Justice Dinesh Maheshwari, Bela Trivedi and J.B. Pardiwala upheld the EWS amendment. The majority bench upheld the 103rd Constitution Amendment. CJI Lalit dissented with the majority view upholding EWS reservation. The CJI held that 10% quota for EWS is violative of the Constitution. "I have concurred with the view taken by Justice Bhatt. The decision stands at 3-2, said the CJI.